Last time I talked about some recumbent cargo bikes and trikes and quadricycles. This time I want to take a look at some home-built ones instead of the commercially produced ones, or at least mostly home-built. Starting off with just this example, this was created, I believe, by Gavin Katz in South Africa. It is a Python low racer. I'm sure I will wind up talking more about Python low racers in a future video, but the distinctive feature of these bikes and trikes is their front wheel drive, which means short drivetrain, none of this chain all the way back to the rear wheels that most recumbents have, and they have the steering pivot right under the seat, so that your legs move as you steer the bike or the trike. And this one has a huge cargo bed. Hello computer, where'd you go? This, you can't see the front end. This is another Python, though. This was built by Vi Vuong, who really deserves his own video. It's riding away from us. It's built out of a futon. It has room for three riders, each driving their own wheel independently. And it's got a ton of cargo space. He's got some videos with this or bikes like this that have a dog hanging out back there, some kids, more kids, that is. They managed to carry a lot on that futon and similar things. This one I love. It is by a Czech builder, I believe, named Mirek, I want to say. And it's got an enormous cargo bed. It's another Python. You can see the front wheel drive. Well, you can sort of see it, which leaves the entire back end clear for cargo space. You can, I don't even know how much you can fit in there. And I believe this was also designed so it can be tilted back and stood on its rear end vertically to store in a smaller space. Not all cargo recumbents have to be trikes or quads. This is another Python, yet again. This one's a bike, and it just has a bunch of cargo crammed in between the seat and the rear wheel. And there isn't any need for the chain to route around that cargo the way you would see on an extra cycle or a Surly Big Dummy, where the chain has to go in between the two cargo spaces to get to the rear wheel. The entire drivetrain is up here. You don't need to mess with that. This one is not actually a home built. However, the XYZ space frame construction principles, I guess you could say, are open source. Anyone could look at the, I think they have plans published for the one seater version of this that doesn't have the cargo space. This is the, it can be a two seater, or this back area can be turned into cargo area. And it's built without a welder. It's entirely bolted together from standard aluminum tubing and other pretty commonly available parts. I've done some tinkering with this own design philosophy myself, which I'll show you in a minute. This is their other recumbent cargo design. It's the four-wheeler, and it's a quadricycle. It isn't front-wheel drive, so it means there's chain running all the way back there. It can support a lot of weight. This is another not actually home built, although you can find plans for building a Flevotrike online, so I'll put it in this video and claim that's the excuse when really it's just that I forgot it in the last one. This, in fact, is my Flevotrike. It's probably one of the first photos I ever took of it right when I purchased it. I got this when we were living in Portland, but the person I bought it from was down in Southern Oregon, and so I took the bus down, took Greyhound down, and met him and test rode the bike and said, sure, I love it, and packed my camping gear into that trunk and rode home. It came with a wheel that you can see kind of tucked in below the trunk there. I replaced it with a 3x7 because I wanted a wider gear range for touring with a load. And it's a great light-duty cargo or general utility trike. Another front-wheel drive design, of course, so the entire drivetrain is up here. The back is dedicated entirely to cargo. And then this is my own take on that design. It is, again, using the Python steering geometry, so it's got the steering pivot right onto the seat at 60 degrees there, front wheel drive, and it's got cargo space in the back that can be a flatbed, or it can fit plastic Rubbermaid type tubs on there for carrying things. And I think that's about it. Yep, that's it for this time. I'm sure I will wind up looking at some of those in greater depth in future details, and I'm looking forward to it.